All right, so returning from the last thing, I have the basics on the Linux side anyways for the windowing and the shared and static library passing of, holy crap, it's snowing outside, Jesus. Come on. First snow of the year, great. Okay, that was a bit of a tangent, I apologize. Okay, as for I gotta go on Windows side now. Windows wasn't working earlier because the Windows Defender was clearing up full screen. Yes, I understand. Thank you very much. Windows Defender kept uninstalling the software that allows me to copy the frame buffer into Windows here all nicely. So now that that is resolved, I should be able to carry on with this one. Let's see if I can, if I put the mouse cursor on here. Yes, I now have it over here. Okay, back to Windows. This with code. So now I want to make sure that the same thing is going to operate here on Windows. CD engine. Did I not? I didn't open. I wanted to open in here. Open that up. Okay. Make a directory, a build a directory. Let's make sure I have variables set for 2019. I've used the command line tools or just the build tools. Visual Studio itself is a bit heavy for what I do with it. As long as I have everything else, I'm good. So CMake dash d CMake support compile commands equals one CMake build type equals debug. Not quite. Okay, arm everything. I want to use Ninja, not Visual Studio. Dash G, Ninja, go. There we go. Make sure it builds. And that presumably in this directory we will have that will not even run at all. Because this is the master, the main branch, I should say. WSI. There we go. Now let's try it. And you can't find GLFW. Why? Oh, yeah, the actual GLFW library. Okay. All right. It's probably because I'm going to bet that it's labeled something different. What? Oh, because the actual deal. Oh, yeah, okay. That makes sense. It's named something differently. We need to. Bring it in, dependencies. So there's several ways. The one I'm most familiar with is find path. We need to bring in, well, no, we already have the headers here. So we don't need that. Oh, but I know, like, if I don't specifically look for the headers, macOS builds break most of the time. They have a more garbage capability for finding headers. 3.h. So we need that at least. Find library. In this case, this will be for Windows GLFW names. See, Windows has a garbage time trying to find libraries on the system, whereas macOS has a real tough time trying to find headers. Don't know why. But GLFW3 for static, and the one I saw, GLFW3 DLL. Because I'm going to bet the static version on Windows will not have the DLL. Not quite yet. Find package. No. So that'll mean GLFW, right? Something like that. Ninja. Ah, yes. Okay. We got that for the library. Target include directory uses the include directory. GLFW include dirs for headers. Let's make sure that's not going to break. Although I can actually just if I go back here, actually build compile commands.json, the compile commands.json. I don't know how that works. So we're just going to create a shortcut. Move it back. I'm hoping that'll Clangd you'll find that. It's not a link either. Do that, please. No! Crap. Okay, let's just turn off all that stuff. And change it to that. New VM, all the usual trouble. And there's my stuff when I was trying to set up the pass-through for the VM. Okay, what was I going to do? VM. Symbolic. Link. PowerShell. Windows. Okay. Okay. Target is the other way around. No, that's right. Okay, so new item. Okay, let's just do this. Does it have to be the other way around? they'd be privileged. Okay, run as admin. I can't see it. Privileged window. Let me just quickly. Let's go back. Okay. That broke the host, it looks like. Run you again. Come on, back online. There we go. Okay. what was I going to do? Do that. Please tell me you're going to... Yes! Okay. Now we're back. We're back. We're back. We're back. So if I restart this, you are going to... Start Clang D? Yes? Maybe not. Okay, I'm going to guess not then. I don't even have it installed, do I? Is that why? No, I do have that installed. Why do I have GitHub? I don't have... Really? You're just piling more garbage on, aren't you? Okay, I'll figure out Clang D later. For the moment, where was I? I got a symbolic link, which isn't helping me at all right now. I managed to get it. Build Ninja. And then I got the Windows, the application to start up. Okay. So I got that on working on Windows now. That's a static library. Let's try. This is the fun part. On Windows especially. Ninja. Yes. Now it can't find why. Now it can't find the headers. Nice. First of all, that's wrong. If we do that, nope. I just turned build shared libs on. That was all. Can home include file that? No such file or directory. Okay. Let's have a look at the include list. WSI. Is that it? Okay, hold on. If I go back to off and run Ninja. Oh no, that's why. Entry point. I forgot to reinitialize the Visual Studio build tools, so the environment variables decided to go away. Okay, yeah. So if I look at this again, it's going to have nothing else whatsoever. But it's going to work. Unless the include directories are being passed in somewhere else. Whatever, it's working again. So now it's just back to, well, it's compiling. Now it's doing the link thing. Can I open... File that. I'm going to believe that it's because I'm not exporting these objects. Yeah, because I don't have a DLL. I don't actually have the lib. Back to directories. Now I need to add the ability to formatting dependency graphs. Let me just double check what I need. I need the ability to create export headers. The ability to selectively export just a few symbols, the ones that will be used in the linker later. So that requires in the root, along with all this other stuff, the fancy graph, clang, tidy, miscellaneous CMake, export, header exports. Now, one option I can do, which is really the wrong one, is to set CMake Windows export all symbols to true. But that'll work. But that's going to export everything. I don't want to export everything. The entire reason of like having these guys with some internal symbols is to only export just what we need, which is these 5-7 functions, and that's it. And then these guys are regenerated by whoever's using it, since it's declared publicly. So, no. What need to do is be specific. So, CMake has this fun little ability to export, to generate export headers. I'll throw up an example in a moment once we generate it. And I also want to set Hidden one. By default, we want visibility to be hidden, and we want inlines hidden. Code that's inline to also not have their symbols left with them. I think I'm not entirely sure what. I'm gonna double check what this one does. I'm going off memory, and memory is notoriously terrible. Okay. Let's delve a little bit deeper. This has nothing at all to do with what I'm looking for. Okay, I'm just going to use it. Probably a good idea. Okay, so we got these generating export headers. Now we go down here and we're going to add a put it on the right side, put you on the left side, we're gonna call it there. To generate the export header. Let's get a much newer one. Okay, yes. It's going to be tied into this. It's going to be, we're going to specify exactly where we're putting it, so it'll be in the CMake current binary dir in exports. Yeah, okay, we'll do that. And then we'll have to add that to this. So, what does that do? Does this ninja da-da-da-da, not quite generate export header really? Okay. Okay. What's going on? I add it before I go to the libs. Then it goes down. And to here eventually. And this guy should have it. Export file name, that. So why aren't you? Am I missing something? Include. Yeah. Okay. Of course, I must be doing something wrong. Something somewhere. Or not. Okay. So under build, libs, foWSI, exports, blah, blah, blah. This is the export header. When you're building the library, it declares functions with this to be exported. These ones to be imported. Now, it's very strange that it's actually building fine. Okay, because it still had the .lib from earlier. So what I need to do is include this. Add it to the library. By for the include, I need to export the certain symbols. So include. Like that. Yeah, you're going to include it? No, you're not going to include it. Why not? Why not? Ah, yes. One directory too deep. Okay, now we're back to the linking issue. Now we add the symbol to here. And there we go. Now, NM version. I don't know what the version is for Windows. Microsoft equivalent of NM is dump bin. Okay. Clibs foe WSI. We check out inside lib. So dump bin. .exe foe WSI lib. That's not helpful, guys. That question mark? Okay. Exports. And there we go. These are the symbols that are exported, which are the ones I have here. These guys, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yep. There's C++ as well. They got all this extra nonsense going on here. I'll not really care too much about that. Okay, so we'll add this. Okay, we'll actually do two little ones. Control shift P. Git stage, just these guys, not tracked. Git stage selected ranges, there we go, just that. Okay, add a dependency search. GLFW needed. As platforms. Okay. Okay, and okay. Better dynamic. Properly determining. Determining which symbols should be exported from the foe WSI library to. Better. Windows, essentially. And I imagine probably the same thing will happen on the other platforms. It's just they'll have less symbols. Because if I was to CMake. Oh, go back to. Do, and say off. Build this. By default, these guys will have like. Okay, now there's. Ah, yes, wrong directory. Now there's a bunch more symbols. Okay, I guess that was a bad example. Because it's just disappeared. Or is it under the PDB? Or is it just like... Windows tools, don't know what I'm doing. Disarm, directives, dependents. Just symbols. No, that's just a whole bunch of other stuff. Oh, there they go. There's the symbols. Yeah, we got a whole bunch more symbols coming through this time. Like all the little functions. Which most of them, like, you're not going to be calling from outside the library anymore, anyways. Okay, well, these ones don't really count. These ones are from the external library, as they're. These ones aren't a good example. Well, no, these ones are pulled out from this library. Okay, I don't know what the Microsoft is doing. Whatever. Okay, let's put that up and switch back to Linux. Okay. Whoop. Nice trap for that. Alt F3, right? Make that not full screen and then move him off. Okay, now we're back here. We'll pull. Okay, now we have all this stuff. So I think, okay, right now it's a shared object, .so. So the same thing should apply. This would probably be a better example of it. So if I was to, on the shared object here, it's wsi and then lib that so it'll have some object external undefined once called undefined, but these guys are defined, they're inside of here. You have like the keyboard, the p window, the mouse, all the callbacks, individual callbacks, the flag, and more of the functions. These ones are the ones that are actually exported. Okay, this is actually a really bad example then, because a lot more is being exported than it should be. All right, I guess I just really don't know what I'm talking about then. Okay, well, there are less symbols, actually. I guess. C11, key callback.
I don't really know what's going on. I could have sworn it would have. Because unless I'm missing something. The CMake CXX default is currently hidden, right? Preset is that, yes. It is before lib, so it's that at that time, which is great. Okay, well, we can probably set one for C as well, just to be safe. Just reading through the documentation. I'm not really seeing anything. Okay, let's double check. Let's have a look at the compile commands. It'll say something like, visibility is hidden, and the inlines are hidden as well. And yeah, I can definitely clear it up. Yes. It could also be because we're in debug mode as well, like an idiot. That was actually, oh, that's probably why all the symbols were still there. Oh, wow. Yeah, of course they'd still be there for debug mode. You, duh. Okay, code coverage. Second enable warnings. Whatever. Okay, this, having this here and this here, not quite the greatest. I'll see if I can try to remove them in a moment. Clean this file up a little bit. We'll do that. Make. Okay, right now everything's there. Yes. For static, that makes sense. No, SO. Nope, it's all still there. Okay, of course these guys would be here because these guys need to be called, like these guys need to have their they are symbols which are passed through to someone else in this here, right? So these guys need to still exist, I guess, without having to be just memory address locations. But like this is still reduced. Nope, mouse pre-processing is there too. Why? Why would this guy have to exist if it's just internal to the library? Because he's only used here within this other function. I must be missing something to do with all this. release mode, dependency graph. Not really pulling anything in. Listen, okay, whatever. Whatever. It worked on Windows. That's a better situation than was before. And it is at least exporting the symbols I want. Actually, let's just have a look what the file looks on here anyways. Exports. WSI export. Visibility, default. Default. No export. Do I have to say no export? I thought by default... By default, things are hidden. Okay, what if I was to add this to, what was it, mouse pre-processing. What if I do this? Mouse pre-processing. He's still there. What if I put it down here? Do I just need to have him anyways for some reason? Yeah, okay. I don't know what I'm talking about then, I guess. Wouldn't be the first last time. So we added the visibility for that. Okay, we add that. I mean, not crazy, am I? If I check the compile commands, which I don't have right now. If I check the compile commands, the visibility is hidden by default. PIC position independent code. It's because of the position independent code. It might be because of that. Can I? No position independent code. Because maybe that. It might be that because by that is on by default for whatever reason. Let's just say set this to off. Ooh, that does nothing. It's all still there. And now we lost PIC. I don't know. I do not know. I must have just been way up my own for so long. I really thought doing that used to removed a bunch of symbols or made them hidden by default, but nope. Okay. There was something else I was going to do. Yes, the GLFWs are showing up in this. what I want to do is, I believe I can do mark as advanced GLFW, which will make it, I don't know why that makes that that, but okay. And that will hide that one, which means we can do the same thing for this one. Because these are just basically automatically whatever. And we'll just hide them by default. Which makes a lot more sense to me. Make CMake format. Okay, this will be formatting. Stage, select range. This, these guys are going to be fixed up into fix up exports. This one will be what? Git log, what I'm going to do, f exports, hidden visibility, better dynamic support. So I need to git rebase f5. Well, we want to move this one and fix, use it here, fix up this, fix that up. So it merges into this commit, so we don't, so it looks as if that one properly had it formatted in the first place. All together. Very nice. Ah, yes, chat, just a bunch of bots. Okay, what do we want to do then? Just merge it in. It'll be a fast forward, right? Yes. All right, cut it there about 49, 50 minutes on just this. It's a bit more time than it should have been, but yeah, so be it.